Hello everybody, this is Ariana from PSOIH, and today I'm going to be going over some of the workflow between Faceshift, Blender, and MakeHuman. Specifically, how to bring a character from MakeHuman into Faceshift, animate him, and then import it into Blender. So, the first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to make a MakeHuman character, which I've already gone ahead and done. You're going to want to scan your face into MakeHuman. There are other tutorials out there for that. If you're not familiar with Faceshift, I would highly recommend watching those tutorials before following along with this video. So as you can see, I have the video feed on the left, my facial scan in the middle, and my MakeHuman character on the right, which is actively tracking everything that I'm doing right now. So, as I said earlier, first thing you're going to want to do is make a MakeHuman character, which I've already gone ahead and done. And I'm gonna go ahead and export him in the MHX2 file format, which you're gonna need a couple of specialized plugins for both MakeHuman and Blender, which can be downloaded on the web, the link to which will be included in the description. So I'm going to double check my file location here really quickly, and I'm gonna save this to my desktop in my example character folder, and as you can see, I've already went ahead and made an export of it, but I'm going to go ahead and overwrite that anyway. So I'm going to give that a minute, and then I'm going to go ahead and come into Blender. So just give that a couple of seconds to finish up. Cool. So coming on into Blender, I'm going to go ahead and import my MHX2. I'm going to go to my desktop, my example folder, and my example character. Now, the reason we're using MHX2 is because it has something that's really required of, you know, being able to use it with Faceshift, and that is we need face shapes, which we can only get if we override the exported data using an MHX2. So that's why that's incredibly important. So the next thing I'm going to do, so to override the exported data, I just checked that button there. So I'm just going to change my import human type to base. I'm going to make sure I have face shapes checked. I'm going to apply my masking so I don't get any extra geometry. And I'm going to go ahead and add my rig because I'm also going to be using that when we get into Faceshift. Now I'm going to go ahead and import. And this is also going to take a couple of seconds, so be patient with me while we wait. Cool. Alright, so there's our character. So, just to demonstrate this really quickly, this is kind of what we were looking for here. All of the MHX2 files that you export face shapes from automatically have all of these shape keys loaded in. So all you have to do is bring in the character from MakeHuman. This is why this is really handy. So I'm just going to come over to the rig. I'm going to make sure that's in object mode. I'm going to go ahead and select everything. And then I'm going to go ahead and export this guy to my desktop. And I'm going to go ahead and overwrite that file there. And then I'm going to go ahead and import. So I just came over to my target here and I hit import. So I'm going to load in a new target. I'm going to go back to my desktop. And I'm going to open that up. All right, cool. Came a little bit sideways here. I'm just going to straighten that out a little bit. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here to my joints here. These are all of the joints that come with the default Faceshift character. So I'm just going to match up his neck to this character's neck joint. So I'm just going to double click here in the target slot, and I'm going to scroll down until I find his neck joint, which is right here. And that moves my character down so that both of their neck joints are level. And then I'm just going to highlight this number. I'm going to press up on my keyboard to scale him up as far as he needs to be scaled, just so that I have a good reference for doing my facial mapping, which I'm going to do right now. So, just to give you an example of how this would work, let's find a good one. So, cheek puff works. So the way this works is when you select a blend shape from over in this column, you find the blend shapes in this column that match up to your Make Human character. So I'm just going to find this one here and this one here. And so I just made this blend shape match up to his facial blend shapes for puffing out his cheeks. Now I'm just going to go ahead and save this mapping to my example character, and I'm going to say save. Normally this wouldn't be here, but I was working with this earlier today, so I'm just going to go ahead and overwrite that and say yes. Cool. So another neat thing is that if I wanted his cheeks to puff out just a little bit wider, I can say I want that to be 3, although that's really egregiously large. But I just wanted to demonstrate that you don't necessarily need to stay within 0 and 1. You can even go in and add negative values. So you can also add fractions. But there we go. So you can sink in his cheeks if you want to. But I'm just going to leave that back at positive 1. And if I were going to use this mapping for my facial tracking, I would go ahead and hit OK. But since I'm only showing you guys this so that you have an idea of how you would go about doing this, and you would basically do this for every shape inside of the Faceshift default character, you would hit OK, and then your character would show up in here. But since I already have this done, I'm going to show you really quickly what I have. So I'm going to hit edit instead of import. So edit allows you to kind of say okay, and then you have your character over here on the right with all of the facial mappings that you have already mapped out, so that you can kind of test how flexible his face is as you're working on it. And then, you know, if you need to edit it more, then you can come over to edit and you can say, okay, I want to continue playing around with this. So for this particular shape, I believe this is mouth left, nope, lip stretch. So these are all the face shapes that I have mapped out for this particular blend shape. And you can kind of see some of the others that I've worked on as well. So that's what I have thought looked good. So hopefully that gives you a better idea of what other things you can do to kind of get the shape that you want. So say that I'm perfectly happy with this character, I'm going to hit OK, and he's going to show up in my window again. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and hit record. So I'm going to record a clip. I'm going to make some faces at the camera, and then I'm going to hit, well, record again to save that. And now I don't want to retrack the clip, but I do want to export it. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to right click, and I'm going to say export FBX. I can't talk today. And then I'm going to come over to my desktop again in my example character folder. I'm just going to overwrite, well, yeah. I'm just going to overwrite that, and I'm going to make sure that my target is actually my character. So it is. And I'm going to go ahead and hit save. And yes, I want to overwrite that. And I'm going to come back into Blender and start a new scene and hit reload. And there's my default scene. And I'm going to import the FBX from my desktop of that clip. And there's our character. So now I'm just going to select his armature. I'm going to hit play. And now he's making faces at you. So hopefully this tutorial was helpful for you. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. And I will see you next time.